Welcome to Daniel Hand Tigers Wrestling 2012. Yeah, let's get it started. Let's get it started.
Time you're can't stand still to some bang your spine. Just bob your head like me, Apple D. Up inside your club or in your Bentley. Get messy, loud and sick. Your mind fast, mama on another head trip. So come them now, do not correct it. Let's get ignorant, let's get hectic.
Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoked,
come on,
get started,
come on,
get started, get started. Let's get it started. Let's get it started.
Okay, Daniel Hand's Josh Lewis is now wrestling Joe Martone from Brantford. This is the semifinals of the 113 weight division. in the previous match that we didn't have the announcing on, Matt Elias pinned Liam Callahan from four and in the first period. The score is 0-0 with 39 seconds in the first period in this match. With 15 seconds left in the match, the score is still scoreless. Both wrestlers are trying to gain position. And with 1 second left in the period, Jonah Lewis got a takedown for a 2-0 lead. At the end of the first period, the score is hand 2, Brantford 0. Okay, Brantford elected to defer, and Jonah elected to defer, and Brantford selected to be on the bottom for the beginning of the second period. Okay, 1:30 left in the period, no change in score. Okay, two back near fall points were awarded to Jonas, so he is now 4-0. And the Brantford wrestler has escaped, Joe. So now the score is 4-1. With 53 seconds left in the second period. Lewis gets a takedown for a 6-1 score. 15 seconds left in the period. And he'll ride him out. Oh. And he got 3 near fall points as the period ends. So now the score is Hand 9, Brantford 1. Okay. Lewis had choice that round and elected to choose neutral. Both wrestlers fighting for position. Okay, Joe Mortone gets a single in, but went out of bounds before he could score a takedown. Again, Martone's in deep and does not maintain possession before going out of bounds, or control rather. So with 1:13 left in the third period, the score is still Hand 9, Brantford 1. Quarterfinals, Jonah beat Phil Maines from Jonathan Law with a pin, and Joe Martone had a bye, being the second seed. Okay. Got a headlock in there. And a reversal for now for Jonah. Okay, and both wrestlers are out of bounds with 6 seconds. Joe Martone got a takedown with 2 back points, and then Jonah got a reversal for 2 points. So now the score is 11-6, Hand with 6.5 seconds left. And that's the final score. Jonah will now go on to the finals to likely wrestle the Xavier wrestler. I'll sit next to you and give you the names, Jack. How's that? Whatever you like to do. Okay, at the 120 weight class, Will Crisco is wrestling the 120-pound wrestler from Xavier. Kaczynskis. Alex Kaczynskis. Will has a takedown already, so it's 2-0 with 1 minute to go in the first period.
And number 1 with 42.5 points, Daniel Hand.
These wrestlers just wrestled last Wednesday, and Will had a major decision victory, so they're very familiar with each other already. Will has another takedown for a 4-1 lead with 25 seconds to go in the first period. Maintains control as the wrestlers go out of bounds. There's 12 seconds left to go in the first period. Again, Crisco maintains control with the leg, and it looks like there'll be no change of points as the period comes to an end. At the end of the first period, 4-1. Hand. Okay. Hand defers. Xavier likes to go down, but Hand elects to give up the 1 point, so they're wrestling neutral right now. The score is Hand 4, Xavier 2. Grissom goes in for a single and gets the takedown. Score is 6-2, minute 40. Grisco's trying to turn them to get back points. Kuzinkis is fighting it very strongly. Okay. Grisco has him on his back for at least two near fall points. That's what's been awarded. Two near throw points, so the score now is 8-2 with 30 seconds left to go in the second period. Okay, with 1.5 seconds left, there's no change of scores. They're out of bounds. They'll resume wrestling. And that's the end of the period. Again, the score, Hand 8, Xavier 2. It's Crisco's choice this time. He elects to choose down. Crisco gets an escape for an additional point. The score is now 9-2, Hand. Okay, both wrestlers are out of bounds with no change of score. On the middle mat, there's another Hand wrestler. Looks like Max Flanagan is against Sean Kellett from Shelton. So we'll be going back and forth. Max is wrestling at the 126 weight class. It was down 2-0 with the Shelton having a takedown. Over on the 120 weight class mat, Crisco still maintains the lead of 11-2 over Xavier. Okay, looks like he's got two additional near fall points for Crisco. So he's up 13-2. And on the mat number two, Flanagan still is no change of score with Flanagan trailing 2-0 with 38 seconds left in the first period. Fifteen seconds left in the Crisco match. Crisco's attempting to get more back points, but being fought off by the Xavier wrestler. And two additional points for a final score of 15-2. Will Crisco hand over Kuzinkis of Xavier? Now we're back at mat two. No change of score here with Kellett still leading Flanagan 2-0. And that's the end of the first period. Flanagan won the toss. He elected to defer. Shelton chose down position to start. And Shelton gets a quick reversal. Kellett still on top and maintaining that, maintaining control. Attempting to get more back points on Flanagan, but Flanagan fights it off. Max is attempting to... Looks like it might be a stalemate very shortly. Nope. 40 seconds, they're near the out of bound lines and they both go out of bounds. So 40 seconds left, the score remains 4-0 Shelton. And this is a semifinal match at the 126 weight class. The winner gets to the finals. Max is still looking to get either an escape or a reversal here with 12 seconds left. Bounce with 4 seconds. And at the end of the second period, Shelton 4, Hand 0. Flanagan has choice and elects to wrestle at a neutral position. They'll need a takedown and some back points to catch up. Fighting for hand control. Gets a single. Shelton's cross-facing. Max is working his way up. And has the takedown for 2 points. So the score 4-2. Shelton leads. One minute to go with the match. Out of bounds with 47 seconds. Max elects to allow the Shelton wrestler up, so now the score is 2-5. Looking to score more points with the takedown. No control as they both wrestlers go out of bounds. There's 35 seconds left. The score remains Shelton 5, Hand 2. Again, the winner goes on to the finals at 126 weight class. And Shelton gets a takedown. Oh, now he does. He makes the score 7-2. Final score is Shelton 7, Hand 2. Kellett goes on to the finals. Maxwell will be going into the consolation bracket to fight for third place. Okay, at 132, we have Justin Elias from Hand, wrestling the Amity wrestler. Justin had a takedown the Amity wrestler had a takedown and Justin had a reversal. It's difficult when Justin wrestles because you're not sure who has control. Okay, Justin had the takedown, Amity had the reversal. Now Justin got the reversal back. So the score is 4-2, Hand. He has a guillotine in right now for back points. Okay. Okay. Justin's in a pinning position, but the Amity wrestler fought out of it. And Justin got awarded the 3 back points as the hold was released. The score now is Hand 7, Amity 2. Jack, do you know the name of the Amity wrestler?
Yes.
Dan Grober from Amity. Okay, Justin has a cradle in for some additional back points. And they go out of bounds. Two back points were awarded to Justin, and one escape point was awarded to Amity. So the score right now with 1.5 seconds left is 9-3, Hand.
Okay, switching the mic here. Many thanks to my good friend Steve for doing most of the matches up to this point. This is Jack Roth. I assume that I'll be taking over from here, but I might have Steve pick up a few. That's Steve Anderson. So we pick up in the second period, Elias and Grober. And Elias is up 9-3. Grober's in number 3 seed coming into the tournament. And Justin is the number 2. As Grober reverses. Making the score 11-5. 107 left in the second period. If you just joined us, this is the SEC Championships. The semifinals are running right now. 3 mats running in Polson Gym as Elias gets his base underneath him. Let's see if Justin can stand up here. 45 seconds left in the second period. As expected, this is a close one between Daniel Hand and Xavier. It's going to go right down to the finals. And they slide out of bounds with the clock running a little long. 30 seconds left on the clock. Earlier this week in a dual head-to-head competition against Xavier, Hand walked off with that one. But we know that Xavier is a terrific tournament team, as well as Daniel Hand is, so it's going to be an exciting one. We know that Xavier would love nothing more than to take the championship and win back-to-back. Off the whistle, Elias able to reverse. He might pin here. No. He's got two sitting on the mat, though, for near fall points. Justin trying to sneak in a half. Grober underneath turtling up. Grober gets to his feet. Elias stays with him, and time runs out. We're going to go to the third period with the score 15-5 in favor of Elias. And we start the third period with Elias on the bottom. Elias, quick sit out and reverses, gets two. It's now 17-5. Justin's going to try to get a tech or a pin here. Coming into this match, Elias. Beat Voyerer from Fairfield Prep, number 7 seed, by a decision of 16-5. And now he's going up against Grober. Justin's got a 12-point spread going here, so he's got a major decision for the team. As Grober is able to reverse, he gets two. 17-7, Justin's still got a major. 1:05 left, they slide out of bounds. Off the whistle, Elias gets up. Brought back down to the mat. Justin, able to roll, he gets two, and now he has near fall once again. He's got three sitting on the mat. Yep, so that's gonna be tech fall for Justin Elias. On the reversal and then the near fall exposure, that makes the spread more than 15 points, so he'll advance now to the finals. Congratulations, Justin. Yep. Okay. We had a little discussion going on here in Studio A from the tippy top of the Pulsum Gymnasium, and unbeknownst to us, one of the biggest matches of the day started.
In the hole, mat one.
Tucker McGregor, seated number one at 138, is facing Brendan Butler, the fourth seed from Xavier. This is a key match. There's 53 seconds left in the first period. Scoreless as both wrestlers trying to size the other up. McGregor going one-on-one. He goes to the collar tie. Dan circles around, trying to look for an opening. Butler tries to shrug. Fended off by McGregor. McGregor beat Brendan this week at the Xavier duel by a score of 13-2. You are right, Steve. I can't read my cryptic notes from that night. I brought them along just in case. Yes. That would have been it would have been more of a blowout there, wouldn't it? Yeah, that was a close match. So I'm sure that Butler would love to avenge himself today. And the first period runs out with a score 0-0. Okay, they toss the coin. McGregor wins. Alexis start on the bottom. He wants to score first in case this match goes overtime. So an escape point here would put him in good position if they went all the way to the end of overtime. Butler with the tight waist. McGregor sits out, tries a tripod in, but that's blocked. Butler trying the turn, not there. McGregor goes back to his base. 1:22 left in the second period. McGregor trying to circle through, being prevented by Butler with the lace around the leg. Actually, no, that's Tucker who had the advantage. He gets a reversal, goes ahead 2-0 with 1 minute left in the second period. Now Butler gets to his feet, tries to face him and escape, but they slide out of bounds with no change in control. Score is still 2-0 in favor of McGregor. Off the whistle. Butler up to his feet, brought back down by Tucker. And they go out of bounds. Butler back up to his feet, trying to turn in the face McGregor. Tucker brings him back down, but out of bounds. They'll restart with 44 seconds left in the second period. And they restart. Butler turns to face. He's going to get one, he does. And they slide out of bounds. They'll start in the neutral position. Tight match, 2-1 in favor of McGregor with 30 seconds left in the second period. We're going to have a stoppage here. For a moment, I think we might have a blood time here. Yep, that's what it is, contact lens. As Jeff pans, watch a couple of the other matches here. We were expecting a larger crowd, but because of the possible snowstorm, the tournament was moved to Sunday. Unfortunately, that wiped out the youth tournament here this week as we restart over on the McGregor match. 25 seconds left in the second period. McGregor up 2-1. As Butler drives forward, taking McGregor out of bounds. 14 seconds left. Off the whistle, Butler shoots. Blocked, good down block by Tucker McGregor. He's got to be careful. Is that good job? He's circling in. Now McGregor tries to shrug. Butler gets a chance, he moves it to an underhook. And the time is going to run out on the period. It is now Xavier's choice. You'll see Butler start on the bottom. He wants to get an escape to tie this match. And I think that's a good call. McGregor elects to let Butler up, gives him the 1 point. That ties the match at 2, but it prevents the reversal. And Tucker thinks he might have a good shot at taking down Butler on his feet. Let's see what happens here. McGregor trying to snap Butler's head down, see if he can create an opening. Good heavy hands on the top by Tucker. You can see the amount of effort that this match has taken from both of these wrestlers. 1:22 left in the third period. Score is tied 2-2. And the winner of this match is going to go to the finals. And this is Hand versus Xavier. So team points are key here. 55 seconds left. Tucker's got a circle. That's it. Stays inside. Now McGregor making forward progress. Hard snap on the head. Brings him down. Is he going to be able to score? Goes in the underhooks. He's got to get back to his feet. They return to the neutral position. And they slide out of bounds with 39 seconds left. Seconds left. The wrestlers in a clinch. Butler doing a little Greco-Roman hold there. Shoots at the side of the mat. 12 seconds left, and they slide out of bounds. Butler wants this win. That may be costly if he does something that's not the smartest thing to do here. If he opens himself up on a wild shot, doesn't. We're going to go to overtime with the score tied 2-2. First overtime period, sudden death. 1 minute. They both start in neutral. Butler tries a shoot. McGregor goes under, gets a chance for it. Goes to an underhook. Holy smokes. The match is going to be over. Oh, that's a tough one. Good match by both wrestlers, though. So Butler will advance to the final. And McGregor is going to go down to the consies. Final score of that match, 4-2. We now join Jake Savoca for Daniel Hand at the 145 semifinals against Nathan Misbach from Guilford. Jake goes in, gets a single, pretty move, moves up, gets two. He goes ahead 2-0 with 1:24 left in the first period. They slide out of bounds. Savoca gets the hook in. Gets near fall exposure, 3. 2 points should be sitting on the mat, they are. Still 2. 2 points awarded now, so he goes up 4-0 with 45 seconds left in the first period. Savoca, I turn my head for a second. Pin, Jeff? Savoca gets the pin. Congratulations, Jake. I'm trying to figure out how you got to where you were, and you pinned on me. Guess what?
so fast. You missed a pin?
3, 1, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8.
I did it wrong? Okay. All right, never mind.
Okay. We got two going on at once here. Weibel's coming up on that one. Ben Onofrio at 152. Facing another Xavier Hand matchup. He's facing Nishan Valentini from Xavier. Valentini, during the duels meet this week, went against Savoca as the coaches moved Savoca up one bracket. Excuse me. No, Savoca stayed at 145. So it was the Xavier coaches who moved Valentini up to 152. Still scoreless, 51 seconds left. Stalling caution issued against Onofrio. 44 seconds left. Valentini now trying to put the pressure forward. Onofrio, good job trying to circle in. They slide out of bounds. 28 seconds left in the first. Onofrio now with forward movement. Tries to shoot a Valentini, but he runs out of mat. 2 seconds left in the first period. The score is still 0-0. And they run out of time. They'll go to the second. Here's the flip. It will be Xavier's choice. He defers. They're going to put Ben down. Off the whistle, Onofrio gets to his feet. Moving forward, looking for some room, trying to clear his hips out. Get some distance, running out of mat, sits down. Will he be able to reverse though? Yes, he is. Valentini scrambles, trying to prevent Onofrio from the takedown, but Onofrio goes up 2-0. Now, let's see if Onofrio can work here. Trying to look for a half, gets in under. Valentini gripping his hands, trying to defend. Valentini gets his knees underneath him. He's got his pace. Onofrio stays heavy on top. Able to drive him back down to the mat. 1:14 left in the second period. Ben working to try to keep Valentini in, and Valentini, they slide out of bounds. They will restart with 59 seconds left in the second period. Off the whistle, Valentini sits. And he's going to get the switch that ties it up. Going to stop that as Onofrio gets up, but with Valentino on his back, that's a potentially dangerous position, so they'll restart with Onofrio on the bottom. Ben gets his base underneath him, now working on hand control. Valentini with a knee bump, drove him back down. They circle around. Ben again has his base underneath him. Valentini trying to drive an armbar in. Onofrio able to break that off. 15 seconds left in the second period. This match is tied 2-2. Valentini again tries, but Onofrio swims out of that. Valentini again tries with the armbar. That's a one-on-one underneath, trying to get exposure. Ben sits out, and we run out of time. We're going to go to the third period with the score tied 2-2. Xavier deferred their choice in the second period, so he now gets choice, and he'll start on the bottom. Onofrio's got to keep him down on the mat. We'll try to pin. Valentini sits out. Brought back down by Onofrio. Now Onofrio trying to see if he can get some near fall exposure here. Goes with the armbar. He's got a spin behind. He does. Valentini gets his base. Valentini now standing up. Onofrio lets him out for one. So Ben's got a score here with 1:22 left. Valentini's up 3-2 in the third period. Onofrio's got to be careful about backing up here. Had one stall caution issued in the first period. They slide out of bounds, they'll restart. 1:06 left in the third period. Valentini from Xavier. Again, this match is who goes to the finals. So there's advancement points at stake for the team. Substantial points. Seconds left. Onofrio's being driven out of bounds. And they'll restart with 44 left. Ben looking for the takedown. Down block by Valentini. Onofrio giving up some weight in this class. He's been able to fill in at 145 when asked for by the coaches at Daniel Hand. And they call a stalemate. 19 seconds left in the third period. We should see Onofrio try to explode right off the whistle here. Sets it up, goes for a double. Ben gets him up, can he get two? Oh, they slide out of bounds. 12 seconds left. You can see Valentini, very, very hot. He's sweating. Onofrio sets it up, he's got to get on this one. Valentini down blocks, 5 seconds left. Not gonna do it. What a good match. It tries right at the end, but what a good match. Ben Onofrio almost had him if he had a little more mat room. But Valentini wins that by a score of 3-2. And he'll go to the finals, and Onofrio will go to the consolations. Okay. This is Kevin Weibel. And he's wrestling Billy James from Cheshire. Weibel gets two for the takedown. This is the 170 weight class semifinals. On the way here, in the quarterfinals, Weibel pinned Anthony Volturno of Jonathan Law. He pinned him in 44 seconds. And Billy James beat Matt Barnett from Prep with the decision 12-9. Weibel extending, trying to get some exposure here for near fall. He's up too high. Not Kevin's up too high. The Cheshire wrestler's up too high. Kevin puts a little pressure on his back. He should have two. Other two on the mat there.
In the hole, mat 3, 195. Yep. Will DeMayo Shelton, Marcus Itano Guilford, mat 3.
Weibel trying to see if he can pin here, putting pressure with his chin on the shoulder.
In the hole, mat 1, 152. Nick Pugasis, Chelsea,
as James fights it off with the bridge. But now let's see if Kevin can pin here. He's got the half. 10 seconds left in the first period. Can Kevin put pressure down? Jane's fighting off. Kevin trying to put pressure. 3, 2, not gonna happen this period. Weibel goes up by a score of 5-2 with 3 near fall points awarded. 5-0. That's, see, Steve, it's like a disease. If you go away, I actually, if you go away, nobody else corrects me, so I'm always right. 5-0. And we start with James on the bottom. Weibel with a good tight waist. Trying to step over. Moving forward, steps up. They call it a potentially dangerous situation, so they're going to restart with 1:45 left in the second period. Weibel with the armbar. And James goes back down to the mat. Weibel again trying to see if he can get near fall. There goes the count. 3, 4. 2 near fall awarded as Kevin keeps the hold, gets up, lets him out. He gets 2 near fall, and James gets 1 for the escape. That makes the match 7-1 with 55 seconds left in the second period. Weibel, chancery, drops down to a single. Not there on a sprawl by James. Kevin lets him slide out. 39 seconds left in the second period. Weibel driving forward. James tries a single. Good sprawl by Weibel. Has the underhook, shrugs, gets 2 for the control, and goes up 9-1. They slide out of bounds with 6 seconds left in the second period. Reversal by James, gets a cradle. Time runs out in the second. Score is 9-3 in favor of Weibel. They restart. James gets a single. Weibel with the wizard defending. Drops down. James circles. Weibel has the leg, drives forward. Good hip position by Kevin Weibel. He's got to break that arm. Good, careful, calculated wrestling by Kevin Weibel. He gets 2 for the takedown. Goes up 11-3. Weibel again trying to get some near fall points here. Go, 55 seconds left. Kevin looking for a pin. He's got a major decision working now. Gets a half in, able to put some pressure on. James has his base down. He's blocking with that outside knee. Weibel putting the weight down and driving forward. He's got 13 seconds. James goes over, goes to a bridge. Able to fend it off. He's able to swing his hips over. Good flexibility. Weibel gets three more near fall. He's gonna let him up. And that's the end of that match. Kevin Weibel with a major decision. He wins 14-3. So Kevin will be going on to the finals. Okay, we're about to start the 195 semifinals. Number 5 seed Victor Puchetto from Daniel Hand is facing the number 1 seed. In another matchup, a direct matchup, Jake Whalen from Xavier. Yep, they walked off with the tapes, that's why we had that delay. Victor, I'm sure, is happy to be wrestling in his normal weight class. He's been bumping up to 220. Yes. Both wrestlers jockeying for position here. 108 left in the first period. Whalen goes under, gets the single, circles around. Puchetto's got the wizard protect. He's got to give that up. So Whalen gets 2 points on the takedown, goes ahead 2-0. 48 seconds left in the first period. Trying the muscle. Puchetto over, gets an arm bar in. Victor cranks that back down to the mat. 29 seconds left in the first period. Victor tries to post his head and get up, but brought back down. Fighting for hand control underneath. Whalen trying to sink a cradle in, but time runs out in the first period with the score 2-0 in favor of Jake Whalen from Xavier.
At the completion of the semifinal matches, consolations will be on all 3 mats.
We start the second period. Thank you. Buchetto trying to see if he can duck under and get a single leg. Whalen fends that off. Again, goes under, gets a single, trying to hip forward. Not going to do it, though. Not going to do it. Good try by Victor. Almost had that one. So two on the takedown. Whalen goes up 4-0. Whalen, cradle, locked in. They roll out of bounds. He brings him back in. And Whalen gets the pin for Xavier. That'll give them a few bonus points. And Buchetto will go down to the consolations. Let's see what it can do down there. That's tough when you're up against the number one seed. Okay, we go to the heavyweights. Head to head. Another Xavier Hand matchup.
In the hole, Matt Two.
This is Joey DeMichael, and he's facing. I believe it's Liesel from Xavier. And they slide out of bounds. Joey pinned, He pinned. When Hand was up at Middletown for the dual meet. So it'll be a good thing for the Daniel Hand team if Joey can dispatch Lyle. I believe your pronunciation is better than mine, Steve. Lyle, I like that better. From Xavier. Knock him out of the finals. Also be great if he could get a pin here. Duplicate his efforts earlier this week. 43 seconds left in the first period. We're still scoreless. Lyle, good. Finally, yeah. Stalling caution issued against Xavier. They go out of bounds, 16 seconds left in the first. Still scoreless, 285 is our weight class. This will be the final of this final match of the semifinals. We'll go into some consies, and that's where Xavier won it last year. They won the championship by their performance in the consolation rounds. And then following that, unless Jeff edits this in a different way, we'll go to the finals later on this afternoon. They go to the second period with the score tied 0-0. Michael putting the forward pressure on. Late on starting the clock there. They click off the seconds. That's about right. 1:57 left in the first period. Steve, 1 point awarded. I assume Xavier let Joey up. Probably a smart move on their side. DeMichael, two for the takedown. Goes right into a pinning combination. This should be fast now. He can't carry Joey DeMichael for more than maybe 5-6 seconds. Congratulations to Joey on the pin. That gives some bonus points to Daniel Hand. He heads into the finals, and Xavier drops down to consolations. Okay, we got a consolation match going here. Carter Chatillon Is that prep, Steve? Steve Anderson will give me the name in a minute here. Prep wrestlers up 4-0 with 106 left in the first period. Is that Shane Dempsey?
Brantford wrestler.
Oh, it's Brantford. New Canaan. No, Brantford. Okay. Who is it?
Chris Pantani.
Pantani, okay. And what seat is he, Steve?
Chris was the 7th seed, Carter was the 6th seed.
Okay, so even matchup here. Okay, they got that straightened out. 2 minutes of period says two, but this is the second period. I mean, the period says one on the clock, but it's the second period. Brantford's choice, they defer. Carter starts on the bottom. He's behind 4-1. Chatelon gets to his feet. He's able to get one for the escape. Makes the score 4-2, and they go into the clinch. And they slide out of bounds. Pitani up 4-2. Carter with the one-on-one, goes in for the duck holder. Duck under gets a single, turns the corner and gets two for the takedown. That ties the matchup. Pitani sitting out. Carter trying to suck him back, get some exposure. And he's got the head. He's in a good position to pin here. This would be a very good thing for the Daniel Hand team. And he does. Carter Chatelon with the pin with 1 minute left in the second period. He advances in the consolation round. Congratulations to Carter. Okay, we're about to begin the Consi semifinals at 126. Max Flanagan will be facing Jeremy Dilser head-to-head. Xavier Hand. Xavier right now is ahead of Daniel Hand and team score by 1 point. And so these consolation matches will be key. And here we go. These are shorter periods. It's going to be 1 minute. 1 minute, 2-2. Is that right, Stephen? If I recall correctly. Max won against Dilser earlier this week by a tech. 17-2. So let's see if Max can score some team points for Daniel Hand. He gets two for the takedown. Dilser turtling up on the bottom as Flanagan gets the armbar. See if he can crank here. Hooks the leg, trying to get some near fall exposure. He's got to get those shoulders down closer to the mat. Dilser doing a pretty good job at defending. Max tries again, and time runs out in the first period with a score 2-0. We start the second period. This one's 2 minutes long. Dilser starts on the bottom. Flanagan stays in control, working forward. Some good scrambling going on now. Max in control, trying to see if he can work an armbar across the back, putting pressure on the head. Max in control of the arm. Gonna try to snake through. There he goes. Now he's got near fall. Two, three, four, five. He's got 3 points sitting on the mat. Flanagan trying to see if he can pin. Dips back over now. He's trying to adjust his weight. Dilser goes into a bridge. Flanagan keeping the pressure on. Dilser now rolls the other way. Max adjusts. Settles back. He might have a pin here. Gotta be. Here it comes. Flanagan gets the pin and adds some key team points to Daniel Hand. And Max will go on to the consolation finals at 126. Congratulations, Max Flanagan. Okay.
In the hole, Max won.
Another consolation match here.
Josh Malamud.
Tucker McGregor had a tough one in the semifinals, is facing Josh Malamud from Guilford. Malamud got beaten by Stojanowski from Foreign. Tucker had a real squeaker, boy, against Butler from Xavier. Tough match. So Tucker, let's see if he can get something going. He gets two for the takedown as the period's about to run out in the first period. Okay, we start the second period, and then starting from the neutral position. Malamud tries to go on for the duck under. There goes McGregor, though. He's got it. Tucker, great job lifting him up, bringing him back into bounds. Gets two for the takedown, and we may see a pin here. Tucker's in good shape. He's got the head tight. Scrambling to get that shoulder down on the mat. Malamud trying to turn his hips. Tucker readjusts. Got to be a pin. There it is. Pin called. Tucker McGregor pins Josh Malamud from Guilford. So Tucker will go on to the consolation finals. Okay, we're at 152. Consi semifinals, Ben Onofrio for Hand up against Louis DiNicola of East Haven. As Onofrio goes in, scores a takedown. The DiNicola family, another memorable wrestling family here in the SEC, as Onofrio might pin here. Both Louis and Ben were Connecticut Hurricanes wrestlers. And Louis has two older brothers, Mike and Vinny, who are both excellent wrestlers. But I think Onofrio should be able to come out victorious here. DiNicola posting that leg on the outside. He's able to fend off the pin, but Ben readjusts. So Onofrio gets another pin. He'll be in the consolation finals. That's three pins for Daniel Hand, and that means points for the team. You're right, Steve. We should have coming up. Carter Chatillon will be coming up in the next match. Stay tuned. Okay, here we go. About to begin the 182 consolation semifinals. Carter Chatillon for Daniel Hand facing Mac Thompson from Shelton. Chatillon loses his headgear. And they're fighting for control here, rolling through. No control awarded. They go out of bounds with 43 seconds left in the first period. Still scoreless. Chatelon breaks that off. They go back in the middle, comes in, fighting for hand control. Both get into a collar tie. Chatelon with the underhook, tries to shrug. Not there, they go back in. Carter tries to go under for the shot. Thompson able to spin out of that. Now he goes into a deep sprawl. And they slide out of bounds with 3 seconds left in the first period. Still scoreless, it's going to be Shelton's choice. He likes to start on the bottom, he wants to get that score in. Thompson sits out, tries to circle in on the switch. Chatelon spins with him. Thompson gets to his feet. Chatelon loses his headgear again. They slide out of bounds with 1:48 left in the second period. No escape point awarded as Mac Thompson ran out of room at the side of the mat. Thompson gets to his feet. Carter gives him up, gives him one as he cuts him loose. Scores now 1-0 with 1:27. Thompson goes in for the shot. Chatelon with a good sprawl. Now hips. Good job by Carter Chatelon. Can he keep it though? He may pin, gotta get up on his toes. There he goes, he's up. Wait, adjusting forward. 58 seconds left in this period. As Thompson trying to turn his hips and fend off this pin. Carter's gotta give it up. Carter gets a half in though. Steve's gonna walk forward, he's gotta try to knee slide. Gives that up now. He goes back into a pinning combination. Readjusts, 37 seconds, this might be it, coming up right here. He's gonna lift that head up. Thompson fights that off too, 27 seconds left. Three near fall points awarded to Chatelon and two awarded to Thompson as he reverses. Now Thompson gets the arm bar in, trying to run it over. 2 seconds left. And we're gonna go to the third period with Carter Chatelon up 8-3. This is a good match. We start the third period in neutral. Chatelon tries to shrug, not there, but he drops down, gets the single. Gets two for the takedown and goes up 10-3 with 1:25 left in the third period. They restart. Chatelon trying to get something going on near fall. He's got a 7-point lead. If he gets 8, that's a bonus point. For the team, if he gets the win. 51 seconds left. Thompson not doing a lot on the bottom there. Now he's trying to swim out. Carter takes a quick look at the clock, trying to see how much time he has left. He knows he would love nothing more. Stalling caution issued against Shelton. He would love nothing more than to add a bonus situation to Daniel Hand. I'm sorry. Okay. Steve corrects me. Stalling call against Chatelon. He lets him up. 30 seconds left. Got to be careful here. This could be called a stalemate. Carter's got to stay. He gives it up. And that gives two to the takedown, making it 10-6. 14 seconds left. And it looks like Carter Chatelon is going to walk away with a decision here by a score of 10-6. He'll advance to the consolation finals. So great job to Carter. Okay.
In the hole, Matt Green.
We are now doing the 195 consolation semifinals. Victor Buchetto against Jeff Pettit from Sheehan. They slide out of bounds with no points awarded. So Daniel Hand's team doing a great job in the consies. We had Flanagan win the semifinals with a pin. Tucker McGregor won a pin. Ben Onofrio pinned, and Carter Chatelon won a decision. So far all of those wrestlers are still advancing. Let's see what Victor can do here. Bennett's a number three seed. Buchetto the number five. So record-wise, they're evenly matched. Let's see what can happen here. Victor gets a single. Good defense. And 2 points awarded to Pettit. First period's about to run out. And it does. We go to the second. Here's the flip. Pettit defers. Buchetto chooses to start in the neutral position. If you just joined us and you're wondering about the periods here, first period in consolations is 1 minute followed by two-minute periods. Buchetto gets a single again. Pettit gets the whizzer in. Drives Buchetto down. Pins his head to the mat. Victor not giving up. Victor raising his hips up, trying to drive forward. Pettit gets to his feet. Victor should pull him back in now. Give a good pull. He's got to watch his balance. Go for two. Oh, golly, that didn't work out. He still has the leg, though. Victor elevates. It goes. If he can bring him down to the mat, there should be 2 points here. Referee thinks that, in his opinion, that Pettit holding the leg is not control. Victor's got to break that hold on the leg. And they slide out of bounds. 52 seconds left in the second period with Pettit up 2-0. Pettit with the shrug. Gets two for the takedown, goes up 4-0 with 30 seconds left in the second. Pettit trying to get a cradle in. Buchetto breaks that off. Pettit trying to get a half in. But Buchetto, good defense, head nice and high. Fends that off, 2 seconds left. We're gonna go to the third period with a score. Pettit from Sheehan, 4. and Victor Puchetto from Daniel Hand, zero. We start the third period. Victor gets his base up underneath him, but Pettit's controlling his hands. Now Pettit gets a half in. Puchetto, good defense, didn't let that happen. Kept his base nice and strong underneath. Now he posts an outside leg, stands up, brought back down to the mat by Pettit. Left in the third period. Pettit again. Tries for the half, but he must have touched hands there. He got called on a full Nelson technical. That gives 1-2 Puchetto. It's now 4-1 with 1:16 left in the third period. Again, tries to run the power half. Puchetto fends that off, goes back down to the mat. 50 seconds left. Two evenly matched wrestlers here. Again on the half, Nelson gives that up. Awfully hard to run a half when somebody's got their base underneath them. Seconds left. And it looks like at 195, Jeff Pettit, the third seed from Sheehan, will be advancing to the consolation finals. Victor Puchetto will be eliminated here, but Victor had a tough day against some tough wrestlers. So congratulations to Jeff Pettit, and Victor, thank you for a very, very good year wrestling with Daniel Hand. We'll see you at the L's. Okay, sorry about the delay here. We were just trying to set up, but today the finals are going to be broadcast over sportingnewsconnecticut.com. So we were trying to get on a live feed. We were trying to get the equipment set up for that. And in sneaks Max Flanagan. So my apologies, Max, that we did not start right at the beginning. Flanagan is facing Tyler Bishop from Amity. This is the consolation finals. Bishop tries to go under, get a single, not there. They go back to his feet. Now Flanagan tries to go in for a double, not there. Down blocked by Bishop. Flanagan trying the knee slide forward, but they slide out of bounds with 1:29 left in the second period. Flanagan again. Tries to go in for the shot. He step out of bounds. They'll restart with 1:18 left. Max again trying to go under, down blocked by Bishop. And they slide out of bounds. We're very happy to see Max back. He had appendicitis this year, was out for a good majority of the season. Max tries to go under again. Bishop on a good sprawl. They slide out of bounds. 44 seconds left in the second period. We're tied 2-2. Now Bishop goes under. Down blocked by Flanagan. Bishop has the hand, tries to go on the elbow. They go back to their feet. 25 seconds left. Flanagan takes a quick look at the clock. Moving forward, trying to see if he can score before the period runs out. And they slide out of bounds with 15 seconds left in the second period. Tyler Bishop seeded number 2 based on his record. Flanagan seeded number 5. But that's a little skewed because Max did not wrestle as much as he usually does during the year. Bishop goes in for a double. Time runs out. We go to the third period. And Max is going to start on the bottom. Flanagan quickly right off the whistle gets up to his feet, fights. Good tight waist by Bishop brings him back down to the mat. 1:53 left in the third period. We're tied 2-2. This is the consolation finals of the SCC Championships 2012. Off the whistle again. Flanagan gets to his feet. He gets one for the escape. He goes up 3-2 now. Max breaks off, goes right back to the center, looking to give himself a little more mat room. Bishop working a little deeper near the edge, more near the edge of the mat than Flanagan. Flanagan, the last couple of times, might have been able to convert if he had a little more mat room. Flanagan shoots. Down blocked by Bishop, and they return back to their feet. Bishop goes in, has a single, but they did a headbutt there. That was unintentional. That's got to hurt. Bishop had the single, but good defense by Flanagan. He was able to break that off, snap right back to his feet. Again, Bishop goes in for a double. Good sprawl by Max. Max with the underhook. They get back up. Now Flanagan has to be careful. Out of bounds. And that was a good call by referee Holmgren. I agree with that. They were out of bounds. Thankfully for Max Flanagan, that was a tough situation to be in. Flanagan, the aggressor, moving forward. Heavy. Bishop shoots. Down blocked. Flanagan now moving forward, trying to move in, see if he can. Tries to shrug. Now Bishop goes in with a leg. Max with a hard sprawl. Bishop tries to circle around. They go out of bounds. 4 seconds left in the third. Flanagan ahead 3-2. Watch for Bishop right off the whistle. He should shoot. And time's going to run out. Max Flanagan wins by a score of 3-2 in the consolation finals, bringing some much needed points to the Daniel Hand team. So congratulations, Max, on that contribution. And we're dropping here. Dropping the ball, we have Tucker McGregor snuck in over on mat one, and he's up 2-0, I guess. And he is wrestling, anyone want to venture,
foreign,
I guess?
The foreign wrestler.
Stojanowski, Luke Stojanowski, the number two seed from Foran High School in Milford. .120 left in the first period. McGregor is up 3-0. And they go back to restart with 105 left in the first. McGregor goes in hard with the collar tie. McGregor had the one-on-one, drops down for the single, goes to a double, keeps his feet in bounds and scores two on the takedown with 42 seconds left in the first period. He goes up 5-0. Second period? Sorry. That's Connor Sackmar up here with Jeff Cohen, Steve Anderson. Just like the old days, good to have him back because we'll need help today. As we go to the finals, that'll be coming up shortly. McGregor, one-on-one underneath, trying to do the cross face, open something up here against Stojanowski. Stojanowski swims out of the one-on-one. Tucker trying to get some near fall exposure, not there. We're going to go to the third period with McGregor up 5-0. And they restart, or they start the third. Referee for this match, Garmin Delvecchio. Garmin's an old Daniel Hand wrestler. He's got his name on the Wall of Fame in the wrestling room. And McGregor not able to get the takedown. He's not far enough up the body of Stojanowski. So they're going to restart with 1:33 left in the third period. McGregor drops for the single, elevates, go to his double. He should get that one. He does as they slide out of bounds. Score is now 7-0 in favor of Tucker McGregor. Stojanowski gets one for the escape. McGregor drops down, gets the single again. Good defense by Stojanowski. He breaks that off. They slide out of bounds. 55 seconds left. This is a consolation semifinals of the Southern Connecticut Conference here in Madison. McGregor fakes the shot, goes to Chancery, goes to the single. Goes to a double. Now he's got to turn the corner here. He's got a good double. Stojanowski with a cross face, but it's not deep. He pushes McGregor's head down to the mat, trying to block it. Here comes Tucker, trying to turn the corner. 8 seconds left in the third period. And that's going to do it. Tucker McGregor wins that one by a score of 7-1. Congratulations, Tucker, winning the Consi Finals. Okay, sorry, we joined this match in progress. Again, technical difficulties every time we think we have a little time. Another match starts up. This is Ben Onofrio for Daniel Hand in the consolation finals. And we believe he's facing Chris Crouch from Jonathan Law. Onofrio is up 2-0 with 1:52 left in the second period. Ben in good position here. He's trying to buck him off. Oh, gets a pin! Ben Onofrio moving forward and pins Chris Crouch from Jonathan Law. That's some good key points for Daniel Hand's team score. Congratulations, Ben, on winning the 1:52 consolation finals. Okay, 1:82, consolation finals. Carter Chatelon for Daniel Hand against Drew Pichnarsik from Xavier. So this is a critical match. Pichnarsik tries to circle and gets two. He does. So he goes up 2-0 with 27 seconds left in the first period. When they met earlier this week in the dual meet, this was a key match. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Card, that's right. Never mind. Never mind. Chatelon was wrestling Whalen and during that match. My bad. But they wrestled earlier today.
Yes. You can just say Jeff, edit that out.
Okay, they start the second period with this score. Pichnarsik 2, Chatelon 0. Choice goes to Xavier. They defer. Chatelon elects to start on the bottom. So let's see if Carter can get an escape going here. Chatelon sits out, gets some space. He gets out for one. Makes the score 2-1 with 1:48 left in the second period. That was a quick stand-up by Carter Chatelon. Carter goes in for the shot. Not there. They step out of bounds. 1:38 left in the second. Again, Carter Chatelain, the aggressor, goes forward, gets to a double, but he runs out of mat room. 1:30 left in the second period. And Pichnarsik gets two for the takedown. Goes up 4-1. And they return to restart in the center. Off the whistle, Chatelain. Sits out. Brought down, that was a close one. Pichnarsik on the double arm bar. Tries to stack up Chatelain. This is tough for Carter. Look at him fight to keep his shoulders off the mat. Good hard bridge. Rolls out of it. Three near fall awarded. And now Carter Chatelain, as Pichnarsik stands outside of the bounds, you can see a little fire coming out of Carter's eyes there. Again, Chatelain moving forward. Pichnarsik backs up, little steps backing out of the mat, tries to do a shrug. Blocked by Chatelain. Chatelain down on the mat, looking for an opening for a single. Drops down, tries to knee forward. He backs, returns to the center of the mat. 10 seconds left in the second period. Pichnarsik on the shrug, but they run out of time and no takedown awarded. So here we are, score 7-2. It's Xavier's choice, so he'll start on the bottom. Coaches tell Carter Chatelain to let him up. That's going to give 1 point for Xavier. It's going to make it 8-2. Yep, they did that backwards. They're going to readjust the score here. There we go. Okay, the score went out of sync there a little bit. It's 7-2 in favor of Xavier. Pichnarsik gets two for the takedown, tries to bring Chatelain back down for near fall, but not there. 1:41 left in the third period. Chatelain sits out, tries to look for a switch. Circles, not there, goes back to his base. Swims out of hand control, gets to his feet. He gets one for the escape. He's got 1:28 left to work. A shrug, can he convert here? Oh, golly, side of the mat. He still has a chance here as Pichnarsik stays outside. Carter trying to pull him back into bounds. And they go out. 1:08 left in the third period with the score 9-3. Yep, they did. They set the score right. Steve Anderson, as always, has the right score. Pichnarsik with a shrug, and Carter Chatelain comes right back with his own. 1 minute left. Carter, you can see the adrenaline starting to flow. He realizes He's got a minute to try to do something here. 56 seconds left as they slide out of bounds once again. Stalling caution issued against Xavier. 2 points awarded for the takedown. It's now 12-3. So Xavier may score a bonus here if Carter Chatillon can't do something to turn this match around. He's got a major decision going, so let's see what Carter can do. Chatillon gets to his feet. He has wiggle room. Turns, breaks out, gets one for the escape. 23 seconds left. And they're going to restart with 20 seconds left in the match. Two for the takedown awarded to Xavier, makes it 14-4. Lets him up, time runs out. So Carter Chatillon loses that one to Xavier by a score of 14-4, but Carter, you did a great job all day for the hand team. And does that finish us up, guys? I think it does. Are we going to the finals? We will. Stay tuned. We'll have the finals, which will be fed on SportingNewsCT.com at the same time. It'll simulcast. We'll have the SCC Championship Finals coming up.